So children, we learned a lot of how to solve the questions using tally method, right? Now, the next thing which we are going to learn here is the pictogram. Yes, you heard it right. It is pictogram. So what do you mean by the term pictogram? As the name, it refers picture, right? Picto means it refers to the picture. So now, here the data will be given to you in the form of the picture, and based on those pictures, we need to find the findings and solve the questions. For example, say usually in picture, we will be denoting as one picture to some amount. Say for example, if I mention like this tree, okay, and I have to represent say 70 trees. So it's not possible for me to draw 70 trees in a small piece of page, right? So what I will do is, in pictogram, I will write as, showing a tree as, it represents, say, 10 trees. Okay? So if I give you this information, it means that wherever you see this tree, it means that one tree stands for 10 trees. So in case of 70, what will I draw? I will draw only 7 trees, because for me, one tree denotes as 10 numbers, right? So how many have I drawn? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Okay. Similarly, if I say I draw a star, okay, and I say that one star represents, say, 20 numbers. Okay, so if suppose one star represents 20 numbers, and if I have to draw 100 stars, so how will I draw? I will draw only 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Because here, one star is representing 20 numbers. So which means if I have to draw 100, it is easy for me to draw only 5 stars. Okay, so here, basically in pictogram, this picture will tell us how many numbers it is representing. And this particular information is called as your key detail. That is, it is telling us what is this picture actually symbolizing. So, this is given towards the end of your table. So, whenever you see a table, this information will be given to you at the bottom of the table. Okay? So, based on this key detail only, we need to do our finding. Similarly, you have something called as title detail. So, this title tells us the top heading, that what is it talking all about. Clear? So, to make it more simpler or to make it more clear, we will be doing an example, and along with it, we will be finding out how to solve the question using a pictogram. Okay? So now, here I have a question for you. So now, here you need to find out the cloudy days in the month of July. Okay? So, this is called as my title heading. Now I have given you the heading as cloudy days, and I will be representing the cloud using this symbol. Okay, so this will be my key detail. Okay, so now I have here as number of weeks and here I have number of days. Once again, it's number of cloudy days. Okay. So, I write here as week 1, week 2, week 3, and week 4. Okay, and here I will be drawing it using the symbol. So my key detail, let me put you the key detail towards the end to make it more clear. Okay, so I will be using this cloud at the bottom of the table. So this represent cloudy days. Okay, and one cloud is equal to 5 days. Okay, so which means that whenever see the symbol of a cloud, one cloud represent 5 days. So in week 1, okay, so here I am going to represent the number for my sake. So I will be writing here the number for my sake. Okay, so this is for my understanding to make it clear. So as I said that one cloud represent 5 days. So in week 1 I have 1 and 2, which means that 5 and 10. So for me the first one is 10. Okay, the second one says 1, 2, 3, which is 5, 10, and 15. Okay, the next one is only 1, which means it is 5. Okay, the next one says 1, 2, 3, and 4, which means it is 5, 10, 15, and 20. And what is the total? Shall we count the total? It's 5 plus 5 here, 10. 1 plus 1, 2. 2 plus 1, 3. And 3 plus 2, 5. So I have a total of 50 clouds, right, in the month of July. So my first question for you is, which week has maximum clouds? So can you tell me now which week is having maximum clouds? It's 1, 2, 3, and 4. So I have week 4. So my week 4 is having maximum clouds. Okay, my second question for you is, which week has very less clouds? So can you see and tell me which week is having very less? Is it week 1, week 2, week 3, or week 4? Good, it is week 3. So week 3 is having less number of clouds. Okay, now your next question is, what is the difference between week 1 and week 3? So week 1, how many clouds it is having? It's having 10 clouds. And week 3 is having how many clouds? It is good. It is 5. So what is the difference? 10 minus 5 is 5. So you have the difference of 5 clouds between week 1 and week 3. So is this pattern clear, children? Are you clear with the pictogram format? Shall we do some more to understand it better? Okay. So can you see the question, children, now? This is a table which shows about the cartoons that are liked by the children in general. Okay, and we have the cartoon serials like Tom and Jerry, Doraemon, Dora the Explorer, Chota Bheem and Krish. Okay, now here it tells us each smiley represents 5 children. So this is my key detail, and then my title is cartoon liked by the children. So are you clear? Are you ready for the questions? Okay, so here is your first question. How many children like Dora the Explorer? So as I said, here each smiley represents 5 children. Dora has how many smileys? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So we need to multiply 5 with 5. Okay. So it will be 5, 10, 15, 20 and 25. So how many children I have? I have 25 children who likes Dora the Explorer. Clear? So shall we go for the next question? Okay, so here is my next question. My next question says, which cartoon is enjoyed the least? Which is enjoyed the least? Tom and Jerry, I have 1, 2, 3 and 4, which means it is 5, 10, 15 and 20. I have 20 kids who like Tom and Jerry. So, to make our work easier, shall we just write the number on top of it? So that each time we don't have to count. Okay? So, here it's 5, 10, 15 and 20. I have 20 kids who like Tom and Jerry. Okay? Next is 1, 2, 3, which is 5, 10 and 15. So, 15 kids likes Doraemon. Next is 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. 25 kids likes Dora. Okay. Next one is 5, 10, 15, 20. So, 20 kids like Chota Bheem. Okay. The last one is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Which is 5, 10, 15, 20, 25 and 30. Okay. So now we have made our work simple. Okay. So we can just easily see the numbers and we can tell the answers. My question asks, which cartoon is enjoyed the least? So can you see and tell now? It is 15, which is Doraemon. So my answer will be Doraemon. Okay. Great. Tell me the next question. Which cartoon shares equal liking? So what do you mean by this question? It means that which is a cartoon which is being liked equally? So is there any number which is repeated twice? Yes, 20. We have 20 which is repeated twice. And which are those cartoons? It is Tom and Jerry and Chota Bheem. Right? So my answer will be Tom and Jerry and Chota Bheem. Okay? Tell me the next question's answer. Which cartoon has maximum liking? Which means that which is the cartoon that is loved by the kids the most? So see the figure and tell me. It is number 30 and 30 is roll number 21. Yes. So my answer will be roll number 21, the Chris. Okay. And your last question is, which cartoon shows neutral liking? What do you mean by the term neutral, children? Neutral means which is neither liked too much nor it is disliked too much. So which is like okay. Okay, so how we will find the neutral is, we will find the neutral by seeing the table by taking the maximum and the minimum. Okay, so my maximum in this case is 30, right? And my minimum is 25. So this is, minimum is 15. Okay, so this is the one which is liked by the kids the most. And Doraemon is something which is liked minimum. So the middle ones are the cartoons which is being liked neutral. So my answer will be Tom and Jerry, then you have Dora the Explorer, and the last one is Chota Bhim. Okay, so apart from the one which is being liked the most and the minimum, the remaining cartoons are being liked in the neutral way, meaning kids neither like it too much nor they dislike too much. So is it clear? Shall we do some more?